Okay students, welcome to chemistry online. See, in this class, in previous class we discussed Graham's law of diffusion. In this class we are going to discuss applications of Graham's law and problem on Graham's law. Okay, see here, applications of Graham's law. First we are going to discuss applications of Graham's law. Okay, so what are applications of Graham's law means? See, first one, it is used to separation of isotopes which less difference between their atomic masses. Okay, it is separation of isotopes like separation of isotopes like uranium-235 and uranium-238. Okay, so for the small difference, here 235 and here 238, only 3 units difference in their atomic masses. So by using diffusion, so these two gases may separate. So which having low molecular weight diffuses first? So it is a diffuses first and it is a diffuses next. Okay, next. So it is used to determine molar mass of the unknown gas. Okay, to determine molar mass of unknown gas. Molar mass of unknown gas. So two gases given to us, when knowing their rate of diffusion, so we may calculate molar mass of the second gas. Okay, by using a diffusion. Next, and the Ansel's alarum diffusion formula is used. Diffusion Ansel's alarum works. Ansel's alarum works on diffusion. So Ansel's, first of all, you know Ansel's alarum, which is used in mines to detect poisonous gases. Okay, so before releasing poisonous gases, some lightweight gases will release. On touching lightweight gases to Ansel's alarum, it gives a type of a siren. So on listening this siren, the workers who are working in the mines, they may left their places and save their lives. So which is nothing but a application of Graham's law. This is application of Graham's law. Then we are going to discuss a problem, very important problem. So here we have to discuss a problem, very important problem. So CH4 gas is diffused, 360 cm cube of CH4 gas diffused in 15 minutes. Okay, like that 120 cm cube of another gas diffused in 10 minutes. Okay, see here, 360 cm cube of CH4 gas diffused in 15 minutes. Diffused in 15 minutes. Okay. So under similar conditions, 120 cm cube of another gas, 120 cm cube of another gas diffused in 10 minutes. So what is the molar mass of another gas? So find the molar mass of unknown gas. So it is the problem. See, 360 cm cube of CH4 gas diffused in 50 minutes and 120 cm cube of another gas diffused in 10 minutes. So find the molar mass of unknown gas under similar conditions. Okay. So this is the problem you have to copy from your material or your textbook. So this is the problem I am going to solve. Okay. According to Graham's law, very important for 4 marks. So according to Graham's law, R1 by R2 equal to under root M2 by M1. Why I am taking this formula means we have to calculate molar mass of unknown gas and rate of diffusion. So volume is given. So that's why I am taking this formula. Okay, here R1 equal to V1 by T1. So R2 equal to V2 by T2. Then substitute these values in this equation. So R1 means V1 by T1 into T2 by V2 equal to under root M2 by M1. Okay. So here you have to substitute these values. V1 equal to 360 cm cube. Okay, T1 equal to 15 minutes. So V2 equal to 120 cm cube. So T2 equal to 10 minutes. Okay, and then M1 equal to CH4. Its molar mass carbon 1 into 12, so 12 grams. Hydrogen, so many, 4 into 1 equal to 4 grams, so it is a 16 grams per mole. So here M2 we have to find. Okay, these values we have to substitute in this equation, then what happened? So here V1 by T1 means, V1 means 360 cm cube by T1 means 15 minutes into 10 minutes by 120 cm cube, okay, equal to under root M2. We have to find M1, 16 grams per mole. Cm cube cancel. मिनट्स मिनट्स कैंसिल, जीरो जीरो कैंसिल, ओके। सी 12 वन जा 12 थ्री जा, ओके। देन 15 वन जा 15 टू जा, देन व्हाट हैपेंड, 2/1 इक्वल टू अंडर रूट m2/16, देन स्क्वेयरिंग ऑन बोथ साइड्स, देन व्हाट हैपेंड, सो हियर 4/1 इक्वल टू m2/16, देन m2 इक्वल टू 16 × 4 इक्वल टू 64 ग्राम्स पर मोल, देयरफॉर मोलर मास ऑफ अननोन गैस m2 इज इक्वल टू 64 ग्राम्स पर मोल। सो दिस इज द वे वी मे सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम, ओके। नेक्स्ट वन मोर प्रॉब्लम वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉब्लम इट्स फॉर 4 marks, अंडरस्टैंड। सो वॉल्यूम इज गिवेन, सो इट इज अ वॉल्यूम, टू वॉल्यूम्स इज गिवेन, टाइम इज गिवेन, देन वी आर यूजिंग R1 इक्वल टू V1/T1, R2 इक्वल टू V2/T2, देन M2 CH4 मोलार मास इज 16, सो M2 वी हैव टू फाइंड। दिस इज द वे वी मे सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम, ओके। देन see one more problem we are going to discuss, here 2 gases, one is CO2, another one is X, one gas name is CO2 and another gas name is X. Here rate of diffusion of CO2 is R1, so rate of diffusion of X is R2. Vapor density of CO2 is VD1, so vapor density of X is VD2. So this is we have to find, it is 22, it is 0.290 cc per second, okay, it is 0.271 cc per second. So this is given data, rate of diffusion of CO2 is given, rate of diffusion of X is given, so VD1 of vapor density of VD1 means vapor density, okay, so R1 means rate of diffusion, so VD1 means CO2 is given, VD2 we have to find, okay. So according to Graham's law, formula, so what is formula, R1/R2 equal to under root VD2 by VD1. So R1 equal to 0.290 by 0.271 equal to under root VD2 EX. So you may keep like VD2 by 22. Okay. Squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. Then what? 0.290 into 0.290 by 0.271 into 0.271. This is equal to VD2 by 22. Then we want VD2. This is equal to 22 into 0.290 into 0.290 by 0.271 into 0.271. Simplify and give the answer. Okay. Next, we are going to discuss Dalton's law of partial pressure. This is important for 2 marks. It is for 2 marks. Okay. So next we are going to discuss Dalton's law of partial pressure. Dalton's law of partial pressure. So here this is very important for 4 marks. Four marks question it is. What is the Dalton's law of partial pressure means? So at constant volume and temperature. So here volume comma temperature are constant. Okay. If you take total pressure exerted by the mixture, means you have to take 3 gases mixture in a vessel. Okay, see, this is a vessel. This is a vessel. I am taking 3 gases. So 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 like this. 1 2 3. See, 1 2 3 1 2 3 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3. So this type of 3 gases mixture I am taking in a vessel. It is a vessel which contains 3 gases mixture. So here partial pressure of first gas means only first gas occupies pressure. The partial pressure of first gas means only first gas creating pressure on this mixture. Only the first gas creating pressure. The pressure exerted by the only first gas is nothing but a partial pressure. So here, first gas 1, 1, 1. Okay, only the pressure exerted by the first gas is nothing but a partial pressure of first gas. Next, second. Only the pressure exerted by the second gas is nothing but a partial pressure of second gas. Okay, then if you take third gas, only the pressure exerted by the third gas is nothing but a partial pressure of third gas. Okay, like this. Here P total is equal to so P1 plus P2 plus P3. Okay, so here you have to know P total, the pressure, total pressure exerted by gases mixture. Total pressure exerted by the gases mixture. It is gases mixture. 1 plus 2 plus 3 is called gases mixture. P total equal to total pressure exerted by the gases mixture. Then P1 equal to partial pressure of first gas. Partial pressure of first gas. Then P2, partial pressure of second gas. Then P3, partial pressure of third gas. Okay, so this is what I mean to say, statement of Dalton's law. At constant volume and temperature, the total pressure exerted by the gaseous mixture which are non-reacting is equal to sum of the partial pressures of the individual gases. Okay, then here it is applicable means Dalton's law is applicable for non-reacting gases, okay, not for reacting gases. So for example, helium plus oxygen, comma neon plus nitrogen, comma oxygen plus neon. So helium plus neon, like these type of gases. This law is applicable only for non-reacting gases, but not reacting gases like NH3 plus Cl2, H2 plus Cl2, like that reacting gases, this law is not applicable. So this is a Dalton's law of partial pressure. Explanation we are going to discuss in the next class. So what is a Dalton's law of partial pressure means? It is a gaseous mixture we are taking in a vessel. So the total pressure exerted by the gaseous mixture is equal to the sum of the partial pressure of the individual gases present in the gaseous mixture. So P total is equal to, it is a Dalton's law. P total is equal to the total pressure exerted by the gaseous mixture is equal to sum of the partial pressure of the each gas present in the gaseous mixture. So P total is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. P total equal to total pressure exerted by the gaseous mixture. P1 equal to partial pressure of first gas, P2 second gas, P3 third gas. What is the partial pressure? Only one gas individually exerting pressure is called partial pressure. Only one gas individually exerting pressure in the gaseous mixture is called partial pressure. This is the Dalton's law of partial pressure. We will discuss its explanation in the next class. So what is the relation between partial pressure and mole fraction? We will discuss in the next class. Okay, so this is briefly a statement is important for 2 marks and the total explanation is important for 4 marks.